To understand ratios, you just need to understand this simple story. Gaurav and Jay used to receive chocolates from a mysterious magic hand every day. But the magic hand was a little biased towards Jay. Every time it gave 2 chocolates to Gaurav, it gave 3 to Jay. 2 to Gaurav and 3 to Jay. Nobody knew why. Of course, Jay did not complain. So the ratio of the number of chocolates Gaurav got to the number of chocolates Jay got is written as 2:3, or 2 divided by 3. This can be read as 2:3. We are basically comparing the number of chocolates Gaurav got to the number of chocolates Jay got. This went on for quite a few days. So every time the magic hand gave 2 chocolates to Gaurav, it gave 3 chocolates to Jay. Now let's count the total number of chocolates each of them have. Gaurav has 4 and Jay has 6. The ratio now becomes 4:6. The magic hand again gives Gaurav 2 chocolates and Jay 3 chocolates. Now the total number of chocolates with Gaurav is 6 and the total number of chocolates with Jay is 9. So the ratio becomes 6:9. Both these ratios, when simplified, will give us 2:3. In every case, the ratio has remained the same. What does this mean? If we multiply 2 with 2 and 3 also with 2, we get 4:6. If we multiply 2 with 3 and 3 with 3, we will get 6:9. And similarly, if you multiply 2 with 4 and 3 with 4, we will get 8:12, which is again equivalent to 2:3. So all the three ratios are equal to 2:3. What does all this mean? It means that if the ratio of two quantities is 2:3, then the quantities will be multiples of 2 and multiples of 3 respectively, and not necessarily just 2 and 3. A few students have this confusion that the ratio of 2:3 will mean Gaurav has just 2 chocolates and Jay just 3 chocolates. If the ratio is 2:3, then the quantities will be in the form of 2x and 3x, where 2x and 3x are multiples of 2 and 3. So ratio is basically a comparison of quantities. But there is a bit more to comparison of quantities. We see that next.